Listen, y'all can't tell me these past two videos I haven't been looking like a queen. I look good.
Thank goodness you're here.
I apologize for any noise that Zaxby makes in the background. He's in this video for a reason. This is why he ain't in most of my videos, because he makes the most noise. But a lot of people are like, do a dog update video. But like, I don't know, like, what does that even mean? I don't know, like, what to talk. I don't know what I would talk about in that video. So I'm just gonna include him more in my channel, just in random videos, so y'all can see what he be doing. I'm sorry. But last week I asked y'all on my Instagram story, did you guys want to see an Among Us video or a Whataburger video? Y'all actually voted for the Whataburger video, which is today's video, but I was like, I want to do the Among Us video, so I did that. Bro, these look lopsided. Bless you. I'm doing the Whataburger video now because I still wanna do the video. I just didn't wanna do it last week. I ain't gonna lie, I got class literally in like 30 minutes, but that class, we're probably not gonna do anything today, so I'm probably still gonna film, but we'll see. Anyways, I have notes on my phone cause I don't wanna miss anything. I probably will, cause honestly, I haven't even like really thought about it. I was just thinking like the stuff off the dome, but I thought I lost a note at, it's right here. But yeah, if you don't know, I have like two videos about Whataburger on my, technically three. My first day award video, which everybody loved that video. Like that video got a couple thousand, you know, couple grand. Not grand, it didn't get no grand, but whatever. People like that video. It's like me getting ready for work. And I understand people like that video because I look cute. That was kind of good. And I also have a video about literally why I quit Whataburger and why I hated working there and why it's literally the worst place to work and how they basically abused all their employees, took advantage of us teenagers. Love that. And then my last video, the other video I did was a story time. I actually don't like how that video turned out, not gonna lie. That don't recommend that video, to be honest. But this is the next video, okay? Anyway, let me get in. I've been talking for like 3 minutes about this and y'all probably don't care. So the first thing I wanna talk about with you guys is the sweet tea. At Whataburger, they have sweet tea, I'm not gonna lie. In the South, like El Paso, Texas, no, it's not the real South. It's not Southern hospitality South. No, just to let you know. Y'all want that, go to Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, all the little, over there, that's the real South. Those three states, that's the South. Anywhere else, I don't really consider it like the real South, like where you gonna get that really Southern feel for real. Like, y'all get what I'm saying? I feel like if you're from there and you've been other places, you get what I'm saying. I feel like that's also in Texas too, maybe. Like other sides of Texas, El Paso, Texas, no. Other sides, yeah. Anyways, the sweet tea there. So basically sweet tea is really a Southern thing. So sweet tea like anywhere else except the South, the real South, is really good. Here the sweet tea is, it sucks. But Whataburger sweet tea, y'all, I like my sweet tea sweet. I don't like no watered down sweet tea. And sometimes sweet tea there would be pretty good. Ain't even gonna lie to y'all. When I worked there, I would make sweet tea a bunch of the times. And the way, if I can insert a picture, I will. The way the sweet tea machine, the drinker thing, I don't even know what else to call it. Like, I don't know, the sweet tea dispenser. So like, we brewed the sweet tea in that same thing and we would also have to clean everything. So of course it should be cleaned every time that like you make a new sweet tea. Yeah, it wasn't the case. Most of the time, 9 times out of 10, especially when it was busy, which is 9 times out of 10, it would get rinsed out, just rinsed out with water. They wouldn't take off the little, like the spout part, like they wouldn't take that out. And like there was like layers to it. It was honestly just a lot of work to do. So most people wouldn't do that. And it just got, like it would get gross a lot. And then sometimes like it'd get busy. So like let's say I was gonna brew a sweet tea and then I brewed sweet tea, but I didn't put the sugar in it yet, right? And I kind of forget about it. That sweet tea probably sitting there for 3 hours. And then someone's like, did you put the sugar in it? Did you put the sugar in it? Did you put the sugar in it? And everybody's like, I don't know. I don't even know. Like the person who brewed it probably forgot that they brewed it. And they don't even know they put the sugar in it. So then they're tasting the sweet tea, trying to figure out if there's sugar in it or not. And if there isn't, they're putting sugar into cold sweet tea that's been sitting there for 3 hours. Not even hot anymore. And so then it's just like, it's just gross. Cause like this, it's just disgusting. I mean, that's not even like bad. It's just like, come on now. And a lot of the time, this one time, this girl, she was newer. And like I talked about in one of my video about why I quit Whataburger, they sucked at training employees. And so a lot of people would get mixed up with the tea and the coffee bags when they were brewing it. So a lot of the time, people brewed coffee instead of the sweet tea. And I guess no one caught it this time. And so someone wanted sweet tea, right? And they got coffee. I honestly don't remember if it was unsweet or sweet tea, but they got coffee instead of it. And they said they came back and they said it's like they got poisoned. So That also would happen. And I was just, a lot of people get sweet tea there or get like alma maters. What are they called?
I most definitely meant Arnold Palmer's, but okay.
I forgot what those things called, but when it's half sweet tea, half lemonade, a lot of people get those, and I don't know, that's just kind of embarrassing.
This is really embarrassing.
I don't know. Honestly, the gross part is just that it wouldn't get clean all the time, so it just got like build up of tea. It's just honestly really, really gross. And then we would have to mix it with the whisk, right? And sometimes that would be gross too, because that wouldn't get washed all the time. And like sometimes it would be sitting in dirty water and then people would just take it out and rinse it up. Ugh! So disgusting. So that's why a lot of the times, honestly, I just stopped getting the sweet tea there, because I was like, I'm just gonna be a fountain drink. And I only had soda there, so I don't really mess with fountain drinks. But Dex, me don't you do it. I don't mess with fountain drinks, so. Anyways, that was kind of, that's just gross. Now, back kind of like around drinks, the shake machine. So, at Whataburger, they have like vanilla chocolate, strawberry, and then they have a Dr. Pepper shake as well. I think they still have that, honestly, I don't know. Haven't been there since I quit. So, but the thing is, the same thing with like the sweet tea, the shake machine wouldn't get clean all the time either. So, it would get like, it was just gross. Like, it would be, you know how like when you have like, the ice cream, it would just start dripping down, and the syrups would start dripping down, and the container at the bottom would be built up, like layers, like built up, really disgusting. It would just look disgusting, like it would be ice cream, and then all the syrup just builds up at the bottom, and a lot of, oh, when, literally all we would do for the shit, like to make the milkshakes or whatever, is, I really hope I thought of pictures, or it's not really gonna make sense. So like, we would just fill up the, every couple hours or whatever, when it would run out, we'd make sure we fill up the machine with the shake mix, right? We put like eight bags in there at a time. The gross thing was, is that, this is gonna be my, water bottle, right? I mean, okay, this is the Whataburger cup, right? And I'm gonna make me a milkshake. I push the little lever down, put all the ice cream in there halfway, right? I get some syrup, I pump some syrup in it, right? This is the cup, right? And then there's this machine, and there's the, it's gonna like, it's like a stick. I'm gonna find a picture. I have to find a picture. And it literally like swirls it up, right? And then you do that. Sometimes the swirl thing will be super dirty. The swirl thing, some like it didn't really get clean. I'm so bad at explaining things. The shake machine, it wasn't really getting clean as much as it should have. And when it did get clean, it just kind of got most of the time it was getting wiped down with the same wipes that be using to wipe down everything else. Like they would use the wipe to wipe down the shake machine, wipe down the drink machine, wipe down the registers, wipe down the counters, wipe down the ketchup stuff.
Oh! Ew!
Everything was getting wiped down. I don't know. Maybe that's just me, but that's so unsanitary. Like, it's just gross. Like, that's, people, food is gonna, like, people are eating that, and it, anyways. So the thing after that is, this is just like, kind of controversial, I guess. I don't really know. I'm gonna say allegedly, because first of all, they can't sue me, because I'm not even talking about, but so if you watching this and you work there, you're the manager, Miss Manager, if you watching this and you trying to sue me or something, first of all, I didn't even say the store name. I didn't say what store. But if you want to out yourself like that, go ahead. That's your business. Anyways, expired meat.
What did he say?
Yeah, I really can't speak much on this topic because right before I left, I barely found out about the situation. I had a friend there, love her to death. Oh my god, okay, I don't love her to death because I haven't talked to her in a minute. But she was like one of my favorite people there. Like, she is such like a genuinely nice, amazing person. And she graduated and she doesn't even live here anymore. But oh my god, like, she's just such a genuine person. Like, shout out to my girl. And like, she just was like, she was so great with advice. And just, she's just a great human being, to be honest. So, she's probably not watching this video. I haven't talked to you probably in a few months. I've talked to her like since after I quit, but anyways, besides the point, she told me that basically there was Whataburger, my location, they was out here selling expired meats. Okay. The thing was, I can't tell you exactly what happened, but she told me that there was this other guy here, he was super cool. He really only worked the night shifts. I didn't see him that often because right when I started working night shifts, he dipped. But he got in an argument with the manager because he knew about the expired meat. She didn't want to do anything about it. And so they were just selling to customers. I can't tell you how much it expired. I can't really talk too much on the situation because I don't really know. But I just know that they were selling expired meat. I don't know when. I don't know how long it was going on, but it was happening. And I really believe this because the reason I worked at Whataburger is I didn't want to work at somewhere where I liked the food, and I didn't like Whataburger because I got food poisoning from Whataburger. The same location I worked at, the same location I got food poisoning. That's all I gotta say. So next I'm talking about the flirting with managers, and this is crazy because I work at Smoothie King now, and one of the, like, my coworkers, he worked at Whataburger with me, but we weren't cool back then. But now we're, well, it's because we didn't talk, like we didn't have a problem, but like we're cool now, right, at Smoothie King. And he was telling me that this one girl, I'm not gonna lie to y'all, didn't like her one bit. None about her, I didn't like her. I just didn't. She was just one of those girls, like, I don't know, she was just doing the most. She was acting like, okay, at Whataburger, I was a white shirt too, I ain't even gonna lie, but I hated being a white shirt. I didn't like wearing the white shirt. I talked about this in my last video, like I said, being a white shirt was annoying. Like, it's, I don't know, everybody hyped it up, and I didn't see the hype at all. Didn't ask for it. I mean, I ain't complaining, but like, I am complaining at the same time. It's, people act like, she's one of those people who act like being at Whataburger was the best thing, that she was just the top of the top. She was a white shirt. She would do the same thing every day. She would wear a bright pink bra. I ain't even hating her. Like, I am hating on her for that. She would, every single day, she wore the same bright pink sports bra, bright pink, through her white button-up shirt where you could see, like, she just wanted to show her cleavage. And it wasn't just like, she would, I don't know. Sorry, I'm getting very, like, loud about this. But I don't know. She was just one of those people.
Now, before someone tries to cancel me about this, I just want to say that I know girls, like, we don't do everything we do for attention. I'm not finna wear something I want to wear for attention. But, like, when you, it's just, you have to be, it's just, I feel like everyone knows, like, those type of people, like, this type of person I'm talking about. They do, like, all, like, when you're around them with a group of guys, it's just you two, like, you with your friends, they just act different around guys. Like, they just, it's just, she give me those vibes. I really can't speak on her personality for real because I only knew her from work, but from what other people have told me, like, you know, I feel like she just did no good vibes around her at all. She just thought she was better than everyone else because she worked at Whataburger. So yeah,
why are you, like, you ain't doing the most, you work at Whataburger, girl. I mean, I work at Whataburger too, but you acting like you were doing the, like, ooh. Anyways, I wasn't a fan of sis. And then she would do this very annoying thing. Like, if she was taking a customer's order, she would, like, bend over, like, she would break her back to show off her butt. Like, she would do this on purpose, and we would make fun of her for it. And she'd be like, haha, I don't do that. And she would also, sorry, I'm just, like, coming for her, and that's not even the point. I mean, it is kind of the point. But she would also complain about, like, she was just such a hypocrite. That's all I gotta say about her. If you weren't with me, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Like, the sports bra, everybody know. And oh, a lot, and it was kind of crazy because I wasn't friends with her there at all. I was only really friends with, like, 2-3 people there. And I wasn't really friends with her. I would be, like, nice to her or whatever because I ain't got no time to be mean to people. But, like, a lot of people were kind of fake to her. A lot of people would talk about her behind her back, and they would come for her, even though every other day they'll be like this for her. But honestly, like, same. But anyways, the reason I'm even bringing her up in the situation is because she is now dating one of the managers who worked there.
Make it 55, sub 30.
Keep in mind, y'all, she's not a grown woman. I mean, she just turned 18. So yeah, she's grown or whatever, she's an adult. But when I worked there, her and this manager used to flirt all the time. Her and this manager used to flirt 25-8. And I always thought it was weird. They'd always be touchy-touchy. Keep in mind, I'm not sure how old he is, but I feel like he's like 25. She was 17 at the time. It's still in high school. And they all like this. And it just made, I don't know, it wasn't like, it was just like, why, I don't know. It made me uncomfortable. And I wasn't even in the situation. But it wasn't like that he was trying to groom her or anything. Like, they were both, yeah, they were like play fight, and she'd be like, oh my god, stop it. I don't know, I'm sorry, I'm just like, I just don't got a time. It's just disgusting. Like, why are you first of all, it's not allowed. Like, you're dating your manager. Why are you dating your manager?
I would just like to say correction before somebody who works there tries to correct me. He wasn't the manager, but he was the shift team leader, so that's like above. It's, you're not a regular employee. Like, you're on the road to be a manager. My fault.
Yeah, you graduated high school. Yeah, you're of age. But that, I'm 9 times out of 10, that it's not allowed. to date your manager. And I'm just like, if there's a 25-year-old and you're 18 and he can't find any a relationship or nothing, I'm just saying, like, there's something wrong with him. All right, the next thing I'm going to talk about is, like, kind of going back to expiring meat. A lot of the times, the chicken would be, not a lot of times, but sometimes the chicken would be given to customers on, like, not cooked all the way. Sometimes, same thing with the meat. Just some, a lot of the stuff, it would be given to customers not all the way done. I mean, there's really nothing to say about that. It's just, like, it's not that hard. All you do is push a button and then you set the food in the oil and you bring it back up. Something else that, like, I didn't even, like, realize that this should have been happening way before, but it's just not really started happening, is gloves. At Whataburger, it's just, okay, washing your hands and wearing gloves wasn't a serious task that they were enforcing until Corona. Until Whataburger said, you have to wear your mask, you have to wear gloves, you need to be washing your hands every 30 minutes. That was not happening. Ain't even gonna lie, it wasn't happening by anyone. Like, nobody was doing that. Of course, wearing the mask, but washing your hands, none of that was happening at all. And it's just disgusting because you're working with food. You're working, you're like, it's a food industry. And 9 times out of 10, the cooks making out the burgers or whatever, they might have washed their hands, but they're not wearing gloves. So that's just gross. And like, they just had to start doing this thing, like, if you're touching me, you can't touch anything else. Like, I feel like that should have already been happening. And like, I didn't really like realize all this stuff because before quarantine, I wasn't really in the back. And then when quarantine happened and the front was closed, I was always in the back. Like, I wasn't cooking, but I was doing drive-through. So I always, like, I just started seeing what was going on. I'm just like, it is nasty. It's gross. That's all I gotta say. Oh, and then one thing that, okay, when the quarantine again started happening, the Whataburger, like, people above, like, the people higher up, they started, this one is so much smaller. I know y'all see that. I'm sorry, it's bothering me. But, I can't even speak. Our store got in trouble because we were, like, the people at drive-through were using, like, the cups to get ice. So the thing about the one I worked at, we worked at a super old Whataburger. We had to refill the ice ourselves. We literally had to get ice buckets, go to the back, fill the ice, and then dump it in and come back until it was full. Literally so irritating. I don't understand why they never will, like, why they're not gonna remodel the store. Cause it's kind of disgusting how old it is. Like, it needs to be, like, a redo. There needs a redo to be done. Like, let's say, again, this was my Whataburger cup, right? And let's say they were getting a Coke. Instead of getting, like, the ice scooper, and sometimes, again, people weren't wearing gloves, so you're touching the ice while you're getting the scoop, right? And you're put in here, but no, they were just, again, most of the time, touching the ice, scooping up the ice like that. I don't know, like, that's just gross. And then, not having gloves on, getting lids, gross. It's a lot of things in there, just like, dang. Fast food is so nasty. Like, Whataburger is not that good. I don't know. And something, again, this isn't, like, just gross. This is just something else that would happen there. The managers would argue all the time. Like, there's this one guy manager and the general manager. They would literally argue 25-8 there. And it would just be awkward. Like, I was one of the people there who didn't speak Spanish, right? And so, like, everybody else who did speak Spanish wouldn't, like, were, like, or just knew Spanish. But when they were arguing with, they would refuse to go to the back. And then I would literally always go to the back and get stuff because they didn't have a problem arguing in front of me because I didn't know what they were saying. I don't know, but I don't know. It's just, it was very unprofessional there. Like, why are y'all screaming at each other in the back right now? Very ghetto, giving me very much, I don't know what it's giving me, but woo. That's really all I have to say right now. There's so much more for me to unpack about how ghetto working at Whataburger was. If you guys do want a video on that, like a part 2 of this video, let me know. That's really all I have to say. He fell asleep. He knocked out. I don't know if y'all heard him snoring at all, but I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. If you see this, comment below Zaxby, because that's my dog's name. Ooh. That made the airbag pop out. Whip with a drop top roof. Whip that face back on the dashboard. Car in a junkyard soon. Tow truck pick up because it's stuck. Can't move. Hood crush. Been rushed to the hospital. Tow, 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 tow. Let the casualties you'll see. Tune in to the evening news.